Good evening, and welcome to the Prince Dustpan Show. Tonight, the spirits of Halloween will take you on a terrifying adventure. Tonight, we examine the gruesome horror that is... Dark Realm? The hell is that? Those of you who have been with me since the beginning may remember this from last year. The opening credits roll, and I see a name, Vincent Bellancio. And I think, it sounds really familiar to me. I can't place it. What has this guy done? And then suddenly it hit me like a ton of bricks. I've met this guy. That's why I know that name. I've actually met this guy. I've been in one of his movies. Yep, this is it. The first legitimate film I was ever in a role so minor, IMDb doesn't even list that it exists. Hashtag no small parts. However, the film is released internationally via Amazon, so that's pretty cool. Link in the description, by the way. You know, even though this movie came out about 4 years ago, and I was in it, I've not actually watched it yet. I wonder if there's a reason for that. Wait a minute. Wait, is that When You're Evil by Voltaire? It totally is!
When the devil is too busy, and death's a bit too much, call on me by name, you see, for my special touch.
But call me by any name, anyway, it's all the same.
I'm the fly in your suit, I'm the pebble in your shoe, I'm the key beneath your bed, I'm the bump on every head.
And it's so easy when you're evil. This is the life you see, the devil tips his hat to me.
I do it all because I'm evil, and I
do it all for free.
Now, I wonder if most of the budget for this movie went into the soundtrack. It's worth it. Worth it.
This is the life you see, yeah! The devil tips his hat to me.
Where I left my tomato soup. I was looking for that. Now it's all spilled everywhere.
Oh, what the hell was that?
So this is Ron Fitzgerald, Master of the Realm, aka Spooky. In this film, he is the greatest gothic illusionist in the country. Or possibly the world, it's a little vague. But he's super famous. And in reality, he is a very talented performer, and honestly, look him up. If you ever get the chance to see him, if he comes to your area, check it out. I'll put a link to his website in the description below.
Wake me up in 3 hours, okay?
How about I wake you up right now?
Are you suggesting some dark, sticky fun, my dear?
Oh, I get it. See, because they're going to have sex, but they're also goths, so everything has to be dark. The story begins with Spooky here having some qualms about his upcoming show. He had a nightmare, and things just don't feel quite right. And he'll soon find out why. But for now, we've got a show to do. There I am! Right there! That's me. Those are my friends. Matter of fact, every pan shot of the crowd, I recognize somebody I know. Oh, look, there I am. Right there. I'm in it a whole bunch more, so I'll be sure to point it out when they come up. Oh my god, I forgot Tim was there. You feel the boom and you see the blast. The lucky ones vaporize into air. No escape when the streets run red. I wasn't kidding, I think the whole budget went into the soundtrack. Still worth it. Totally worth it. I love this guy late on the queue. Oh, I guess I should stand up too.
Jump right into it with this. I like to introduce this simply. Don't try this at home unless you're really drunk. Here we go.
You know what, Spooky? You're right. I should be drunk for this. Eh. Proceed. Ugh. I realize it's an illusion, but damn. Makes my throat hurt.
All right, now it's time to go into the audience. You're gonna have to help me. You're gonna send someone down to me.
Oh man, I remember this part. Oh, this is where they pull Steph on stage.
If you've got somebody you want to volunteer, shout her name out now.
Oh, Earl, tone it down, man. We had to do a number of takes of this one because we were all just like going crazy, ganging up on Steph, pointing her out, and the director had to tell us, all right, you know, you gotta kind of want it yourself first, and then give it to her. But we're just Earl, especially Earl, there just went nuts, and you could still see it. Look at him. Look at it. He's going crazy. He really wants Stephanie to get that.
All right, now, Stephanie, what I want you to do is, with your left hand, which is the one over here, hold that against your, yes. Did you get a good look at that first? No, remember. Don't show it to me, that would be cheating. Oh, squeeze, it's a B and a J. Yeah. Yeah, make your own jokes in the back.
More dark, sticky fun.
Squeeze. Look at my mismatch eyes. Very good. I see an H and I see a P.
Yes.
Good.
You know, this is shot well enough that it does look like she's maintaining composure, but she told me afterwards that she really was kind of mesmerized by his mismatched eyes, because she has this thing about David Bowie and the eyes just... She was melting on stage, basically.
The High Priestess.
Yes,
show us the card.
One thing to keep in mind while watching this, if you haven't figured it out yet, is that it's less a movie and more a concert video. A showcase of Ron Fitzgerald's performance. And honestly, the film does a pretty good job of blending the genres together. It's a live performance with a little narrative, a simple little horror story wrapped around it, to give a better viewing experience. Honestly, I kind of wish a lot more concert videos would do this. Rather than just a straightforward live show, give us a little extra. It's pretty fun.
This next one is a little different. It's only, I gotta take my coat off again. Woo! Oh yeah, it's all good. Okay, here's what got me here. I was wondering what it would be like if you could take the human soul out of the body before death and install that soul inside an inanimate object.
is so inaccurate. If soul transfer were that easy, all I'd have to do is pick this up and then...
Hey. Meow. It's cramped in here.
So after about 3 or 4 performances, we finally get a little bit more plot.
Did you get a hold of Raven yet?
No, I can't find her anywhere.
Maybe something happened to Raven.
It's a crappy thing to say.
I'll get the DJ to play a few extra songs.
All right, I'll call her.
Perfect. 20 seconds of acting. Back to the magic. I suppose you could call it a killer performance. No, you really probably can't. Never mind.
And you, my dear, will be... Come on, I need you now. Now.
You are interrupting.
Damn it, Ron, I was about to score.
You know, I know you're entertaining. I need your help. What's wrong? Lady India. She's dead.
Sorry, Vinny. You'll just have to do your, casting later.
She looks fine to me.
So Spooky here has been having some visions, or fantasies, or dreams. No one's really quite sure. But none of them are real, as far as anyone knows. He's jumping around in time like Billy Pilgrim, going to shows in Chicago, back to South Bend, out to the graveyard somewhere. Pretty good looking graveyard, too. I'm actually kind of curious where that was filmed. I like it.
Join the fold. And when the nightshade yields to the day,
wow. You warp from sepia into color, that's... Whew. That does a number on the brain. What is this camera doing? Did the operator forget to clamp the tilt bar? Come on, John, you're better than that.
Yes. Yes.
Hey, Vinny, what? Why are you watching the show? I thought you wanted to get back to those girls in your office. Oh. Well, don't worry, it happens to lots of guys.
Here you are. What the hell are you doing in here? I'm fixing a problem.
Yeah, that's what you were doing.
I still can't find Raven.
Did you piss her off?
No, I did not piss her off. She's not pissed. No.
She's not pissed. She's not. Well, hi, Vinny.
I'm still feeling pretty freaky, and usually that's a good thing, but I just think I need a break. No.
Yeah! What the hell happened there? The audio just go all Birdemic on me? Come here often! Is this your car? Wait, what? What? No. No, stop. Not into it. Not into it. No. Stop. No. No. Why? No, not the boob. Oh my god, that's Rena. Ah, that's Jay. That's Rain and Jake. Oh my god. I know them. They didn't tell me they were in that scene. And that, kids, is where babies come from.
What's wrong? You don't think you should take a break here.
Where the hell have you been?
We've done 4 illusions. You did some stuff with the audience and took more breaks than usual, but you're killing them out there.
Nice choice of words, but where have you been all this time?
Well, I've been here the whole time doing this show with you. I haven't gone anywhere.
Is that... I think it is. We have plot! We have plot! Only 50 minutes into the movie, we have plot! Yes!
Aria died 3 years ago. You couldn't have possibly seen her.
No. No. There's no way. Look, she gave me her card. See? Look, I know it's blank. She said it was magic.
Spooky, this is Price's card.
Places.
Okay, plot break's over. Back to the magic show.
One eye sees the land of the living. The other, the realm of the dead. Betwixt and between, I've always seen the dream that burns in my head.
Hey, it's that quote from the beginning! And the song from the beginning!
When the devil is too busy, and death's a bit too much, they call on me by name, you see, for my special touch.
And it's just the beginning again.
I'm the pill on which you slip, I'm the pin in every head, I'm the thorn in your side, makes you wriggle and writhe.
And it's so easy when you're evil.
Devil tips his hat to me. I do it all because I'm evil. And I do it all for free.
This is the goth magic Groundhog Day, isn't it? Plot. 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 Plot.
Shall we begin?
Yes, Master.
Indeed we shall. A witch they wanted and a witch they found, and a trial they had in their happy little town. But the witness was a liar, and the witch was already on fire. Yes! Hit it!
Is there some plot there? No. Sorry. False alarm. Yay, we just witnessed a woman get immolated. Good job. 10 out of 10. After the grand finale, all that's left is to wrap up the story. And I think I'm going to leave that up to you to check out the movie yourself. I did write some jokes for the ending. I'm not trying to cop out here. However, as this is a fairly new film still, only in distribution for about a year, and it's not a big name, big budget blockbuster, I feel a little bad giving everything away. I want to respect the filmmakers and support independent as much as I can. And I suggest you do the same. So that was Dark Realm. Is it a masterpiece? Did you think it was going to be? Nobody intends you to take it seriously. For what it is, it's entertaining. It's a good blend of live performance with a simple story. I know I made a lot of jokes about the movie's lack of a plot, but that's kind of the point. The movie's a showcase of Ron Fitzgerald's illusions. And to its credit, they look really good. And there's even a disclaimer at the end of the credits that states that everything is presented as it was done on stage, that no camera tricks were done, no editing was done to make the tricks look the way they did. He actually is a really talented magician, and I strongly encourage you to check out his shows if you ever have the chance. Still, if you're going into this movie expecting some kind of story, you're going to be disappointed. But if you enjoy magic, gothic imagery, gothic music, which, by the way, there's a soundtrack coming out soon, I have it on good authority, beautiful women, and cheesy acting, and this movie has it all. There's no reason not to check it out.
Now it's All Hallows Eve. The moon is full.
Here, kitty, kitty, kitty. Here, kitty, kitty, kitty. Here.